I hate this early bird thing.
Same to me. But the bed and the housing is so terrible, I can't sleep longer, even if I wish to do so. Let's go and set up the radios. No need to switch it on, just dial in the frequencies. I switch the battery and the light on so we can see something. Batumi Tower frequency is still 131.00 MHz. Squadron frequency at the ARC-51 also preset 2, still the same.
Start up the engine. Wolf 1 is already moved to Apron 1 yesterday in the late afternoon. Blake turning.
N1 and one, waiting for 68 and stabilizing at around 70. Throttle generator on and inverter switch to main on as well.
I switch the radios and call tower for tech.
Wolf 3 is damaged. The crew is happy because
of it. The TV tower, Wolf 3. Good morning.
Burn, one of the gunners told me yesterday at the boss.
Good morning, Wolf 2. The Truman Tower. Go ahead.
Wolf 2 at the maintenance area requests taxi to Apron 1.
Set up the instruments for open throttle to flight island.
Wolf 2, Papa taxi, we are taxiway November, and Whiskey to Apron 1 approved.
Taxiing via November 1 and Whiskey approved. Wolf 2.
Okay, Frank. November 1 is to the left in front of the building. Take care of the generator in front of us.
It's this team in front of us. We need to go to the left. I set the intercom to the ARC-51 so we can talk to Wolf 1. Wolf 1, Wolf 2 is with you on 264 Omega.
Good morning. Hear you loud and clear, Wolf 2.
We are on taxiway Whiskey and be there in 1.
Good to have you with us, Wolf 2. Operation over 1 starts in 5 minutes.
land in front of the Mi-8 to our left.
The tuning tower, tactical one, on final runway 130.
Our passengers are already waiting. Land in front of them, but
tactical one, clear to
throttle to ground idle front. Ground forces frequency on the air.
Tactical one, fully flying. He's gone.
Good morning, welcome on board. Nothing to eat and nothing to drink on this flight. They begin with engine startup. It will take a while. Spend a lot of time waiting. It's worth thinking about distance learning.
Copy, Jimson. When retiring, you may be already an adult.
This could be a great idea. Just think of all those beautiful nurses or medical assistants waiting to receive instructions from me.
Three more bodies.
Roger, Wolf 4.
Wolf 2, I am to your left. You follow me. Wolf 1, over.
Roger that. Wolf 2. Open forces to flight items. Prepare for takeoff. Stay behind Wolf 1. Wait until Wolf 1 is on the road. Okay, take off, follow Wolf 1 and bring us in his 7 to 8 o'clock position. I sit all night off, would like to be invisible. Let's use the night vision. Don't want to lose or collide with Wolf 1. Don't forget to switch the ATR 131 to 52.00 and on, just in case. We follow Wolf 1 to the right. Wolf 6 and Wolf 7 went to the circuit border at the Tango Bravo checkpoint. We turn left. Get our passengers to our overwatch position. They will stay in the wilderness for a few days, camping and hunting. Their goal is to spot some insurgents, especially at night when they're using spotlights or sitting around a campfire. the nitrogen off. We need to read our instruments clearly before getting into the cloud. land left next to Route 1 in the outermost corner of this plane. That's it. Let's go out of here. We are already at high altitude, we fly directly to Scarlet Mike. That's another Jordan checkpoint. He is located at the only street through the mountains towards the Titan. That's also the reason why it's so important to check and secure all the goods. always get remembered of the all. I'm really impressed by the Caucasus and his splendid view.
Cross your fingers, Peter, that you never may be down in one of these valleys because of a technical issue. You may be far away from any civilization and very hard to find.
It will be the perfect place for my mother-in-law.
I changed the ground frequency to 52.00. Just here on my checkpoint on next waypoint.
Fantastic morning, and I left my action cam in the quarters, as stupid as I am.
checkpoint at the end of this valley. If everything is alright, you may land and pick up a group of Georgian soldiers. They should have got already reinforcements. Otherwise, we have to wait. Getting passed by your main vehicle may be interesting, but leads to a sudden end of the flight.
It feels like in an elevator, with cable cut and in free fall.
Now, I also remember what I hate about this job.
Glad to see you, and of course to hear this beautiful blade flapping sound. Feeling already safer? We're still waiting for reinforcement. The LVAT is located to the right of the checkpoint. Check to infinity will mark the LVAT with blue smoke, but it may take a few minutes.
Wind is from northern strength. Plan your approach parallel to the power line.
Same problem. The transformer station is located at the opposite riverbank. So the easiest way to cross is via helicopter. After drop off the boys from Tech 2, you should be fly back to Sierra Mike and get cargo down there as well.
narrow and so we stay left at altitude and flying a high recon until Route 1 is underground. It would be unfavorable. He would have to abort the landing and we will be in his way. Start to approach. Route 1 is close to ground. Land close to his left side. Confirmer station and the two foot to check. It is getting late and I will be back in 2 weeks before it starts. Changing the ground and cause the other back. Here are Mike, move 2, 2 miles out.
Wolf 2, Sierra, Mike, welcome back. You may request smoke marker at cargo site over the radio by choosing the cargo. Take care of the power line. These idiots drop the cargo much too close from the truck.
Think about the wind point. Come through from northeast, fly 180 degrees down, so we catch all the wind we can get.
you are. Take tension. Take, the line is tight. Load is hanging steady. Take it away.
Looks good. See you later. Sierra, Mike, over.
See you later. We'll do over. Don't forget to activate automatic cargo release point. I switch radios back to RTL. Rule 2, 1 mile out. Okay, that's fine. Turn right, but stay at orbit.